Story recapped here. Today, I'm going to explain a horror and mystery film called We Need to Do Something. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and take care. An amber alert for a thunderstorm brings a family to seek refuge inside their bathroom. The mother, Diane, scolds her daughter, Melissa, for coming home late after spending time with her girlfriend, Amy. Upset that her daughter wouldn't answer her calls. Simultaneously, Diane tries to quell her youngest's worries, Bobby, who thinks the storm might turn into an EF5 tornado. Melissa starts to become worried both for her girlfriend and the storm, turning to Diane and telling her that she feels something might be badly wrong about the storm. Nonetheless, Diane tries to reassure her that things will pass. Bobby invites them to play a board game, but when Melissa starts to tease him that he can't read, they start arguing with each other. Their argument makes their father, Robert, shouts at them to stop. Melissa texts Amy non-stop, checking in on her, but she's getting no responses. On the other hand, Diane gets a call from a mysterious person, but when Robert confronts her about it, she says that it's no one. The person calls Diane again, but she brushes off questions about it once more. Soon, they get an amber alert for a tornado, so Robert laughs, saying that their bathroom isn't going to save them if a tornado rips away their house. Diane tells him to leave if he wants, but this just turns into another back and forth argument between the parents. When Melissa tries to ask them what's wrong, a sudden flash of thunder surprises them as it cuts off their electricity. Everyone panics immediately, but Robert dismisses their worries because it's a normal occurrence during thunderstorms. Bobby is immediately spiraling, thinking that a tornado will pass through, but Diane tries her best to comfort him. However, when a louder boom of thunder crackles through, they hear a worrying commotion outside their bathroom door, so they huddle together, realizing that something hit their house. Robert tries to open the door to check outside, but he can't push it all the way through. He takes Melissa's phone and uses its flashlight. Then, he realizes that a tree had fallen into their house, blocking the door and trapping them inside the bathroom for an indefinite period. Melissa exclaims that it might be one of the trees in their backyard where they buried their dead dog. Upon hearing this, Bobby gets alarmed, not being told that their dog died. He cries about it, but Diane tells him that it isn't a good time to talk. Robert closes the door, but Melissa realizes that he doesn't have her phone anymore, so she tries to push through the door after saying that he dropped it outside. Robert scolds her, saying that Amy will be okay, and she should stop being hysterical. After that, he tells everyone that the roof of their house is gone. Nonetheless, Melissa is distraught about the situation and asks what they should do, but nobody answers until Robert speaks up. The only thing they could do is wait it out. Melissa cries as she is worried about Amy. Melissa gets a flashback of meeting Amy. They snuck glances at each other while on the bleachers. While Melissa walked away, Amy chased after her and confronted her about staring at her cuts. Melissa apologized, not meaning to stare, but Amy said she wanted her to. Then, she told Melissa that she was a cutter because she used to be dead. The next morning, the storm has quieted down, but they're still stuck inside because of the tree. Diane asks if they can try calling for help again, but Robert's phone isn't working while Diane's is dead. The two argue about nothing once more, angry that their phones aren't working. When Bobby peers through the door crack, he sees a rattlesnake near them. However, when Robert checks it out, he doesn't see anything, so the whole family orders Bobby to close the door. Meanwhile, an impatient Melissa lies in the bathtub, picking at her wrist wound. Later on, she tries to push the door open with little to no luck. She asks whether Robert could try busting through the walls, but he angrily explains that the door is made from solid oak, the windows are tempered glass blocks, and their walls are 6 feet thick and made of rocks. Although it was indeed a safe space for refuge, it's now becoming their own prison. Diane tries to be optimistic, but most family members feel pessimistic already. One by one, they all try to open the door, but it still won't budge no matter how much they try in exasperation. Afterward, Diane asks for Robert's water container so they can rehydrate, but he spitefully drinks from it before giving it back to her. She refills it with tap water and gives it to Bobby, but he's hesitant to drink from it, so Robert shouts at him. Robert laughs, telling Diane that he was joking around, but she brushes him off, mad at his aggressiveness. Suddenly, the electricity comes back. That night, they all revel at how hungry they are, but things aren't so tense as Bobby, Melissa, and Diane joke around with each other. However, while the three are having a laugh, Robert is pacing around in frustration, throwing his phone in anger when the battery dies. He takes out his anger on the door, punching it while yelling vulgar things, making Melissa cower in the bathtub. Another night has passed, and there's still no end in sight for the family. Melissa is getting worried that there isn't any rescue team coming. Robert mutters that it must be something else and not a tornado because the situation doesn't make any sense. He realizes that there surely must be people around their house that could have seen their need for help. Robert's first thought is that their neighbor might already be dead or evacuated, both of which aren't helpful to their case. Melissa has another flashback when Amy confesses that she has a rare mental illness called Cotard delusion, also known as walking corpse syndrome. Amy was convinced she was dead, hence she cut herself hoping that seeing the blood would help her realize she was still alive. After taking turns in the shower, a rattlesnake slithers inside their bathroom. It goes to Robert, causing him to panic and jump on top of the sink as it tries to bite him. Melissa throws him a plunger, which he uses to push a snake out of the door. Because of the stress, Robert's alcoholism gets triggered, so he takes a bottle of mouthwash and drinks it. He realizes that maybe they should have eaten the snake. Suddenly, the family hears footsteps outside and realizes that it's a dog. Bobby immediately opens the door to pet the creature despite not seeing it. Melissa takes over in stroking the dog, telling it that it's a good boy. However, the dog suddenly talks back, saying it's indeed a good boy, and grabs Melissa. She struggles to pull her arm back inside despite being helped by Robert, but she manages to break free, pulling the dog's tongue with her. With desperation finally creeping up to them, they realize that they have no choice but to eat the dog's tongue to fight against starvation. Diane takes over, ripping the tongue into little pieces so they don't choke on it. Melissa takes the first bite and braves through it despite gagging. Though they all ate, Robert immediately pukes while Melissa keeps on chewing. Another flashback occurs to Melissa of her time with Amy when a school bully stalked them around, took their pictures, and spread hurtful rumors about them. As Melissa cried hard about it, they both decide to take matters into their own hands. Therefore, Amy proposed doing a spell for revenge. They dug up Melissa's dead family dog buried in their backyard and took its tongue for the ritual. Amy made it so that anything the bully says about them will be turned back to him. The next day, Robert gets an idea and wakes Bobby up for help. He brings Bobby to the door and tells him to squeeze through it. Although the little boy knows that he can't fit through, Robert forces him even when it hurts his son, trying to push his head through the small opening. Diane pulls him away from Bobby and starts screaming at Robert for his abrasiveness. While the two argue and shout at each other, they don't notice that the rattlesnake has returned and bites Bobby on the arm. Melissa immediately pulls him back at the tub while Diane traps it in the trash bin. They all panic as they check on Bobby, groaning in pain. Diane tries to use a tourniquet so that the venom doesn't get to his heart, but Bobby is too squirmy. Robert tries to draw the venom out, but they aren't sure whether they've done enough to counteract it. Melissa cries, but Diane still tries to reassure her that everything will be fine. Meanwhile, Robert spirals as he bangs the door again, screaming nonstop. Melissa goes to Bobby and sobs, apologizing that it's all her fault, but Diane comforts her. Suddenly, they hear a voice outside from a distance asking if they need help, but Robert can't see the person. Robert shouts that they're stuck inside the bathroom, so the man tries to follow his voice. However, loud footsteps and gunshots erupt from outside, and they could no longer hear the man. Robert tries to peek at what happened, but still he can't see anything. They hear hissing and growling outside, so they all quiet down. After a few hours, they start talking again, trying to speculate what's happening outside. But they turn their worries back to Bobby, who slowly becomes unresponsive. He gets mad at Melissa because she keeps asking him what to do when they are clueless about what could help their situation and what lies beyond the door. Then Melissa starts to have another flashback. After Amy cast a spell on the bully, they found out he had died. Melissa realized that it was all their fault. However, Amy confessed that her spell wasn't to target the bully, but herself. She said because of her mental illness, she tried to do a spell that would bring her back alive, but she felt something was wrong, theorizing that maybe it wasn't her that was dead, but something evil lurking inside her, and her spell awoke it. But Melissa doesn't understand what she's talking about. Still, Amy was convinced that something that wasn't human lived inside her. The next day, Robert confronts Diane about the person calling her phone before, asking why they haven't called her again. Robert knows that Diane is seeing someone else behind his back. Diane thinks he's mocking her, but he's already at the point of desperation where he's genuinely asking if her secret lover might be able to rescue them. However, Diane explains that she told the man if she didn't call him back, something would have already happened to her. Diane and Robert start to fight about their relationship, shouting at one another, scaring Melissa. The two stop when Bobby speaks up, saying that everything hurts, and Diane can feel his heartbeat slowing down. Therefore, she pleads for Bobby to hold on a bit longer, still desperately hoping for someone will come to save them. However, Bobby has already passed away. In another flashback, Melissa remembers how she got the wound from her arm, remembering the final ritual that she and Amy did the night of the storm to try and stop the evil spirit awakening from Amy's body. However, she noticed that this memory was different because Bobby wasn't with them when they sought shelter inside the bathroom. Turns out, she's having a nightmare sequence and sees Bobby's rotting corpse in the bathtub. The world turns red as she vomits blood. Robert tells her that she's a witch and blames her for the disaster. She pleads for help as she rips her stomach open and pulls the dog's tongue. Then her parents kneel in front of her trying to catch the blood pouring out of her. When she comes back to her senses, she realizes she's vomiting on the toilet after drinking a whole bottle of liquid sleep. She even momentarily forgets that Bobby's already dead, his body covered in the bathtub. Stressed out, Robert begins eating wet wipes to quell his alcoholism. Melissa starts to confess that the disaster is happening because of her. She tells them about the spell she and Amy cast, saying that a demon might have been awakened because of it. She even reveals how the bully died after choking on his own tongue. Although she says they stopped it, trying to kill whatever demon or spirit it was, they might not have succeeded, hence the current disaster they're in. At this point, even if the story sounds completely ludicrous, Robert entertains the idea and confronts Melissa about it, trying to find someone to blame. He reprimands her, pointing towards Bobby's corpse on the tub and blames her for it. The next day, Robert has blood coming out of his eyes, his vision impaired. He suggests that they should eat Bobby because they need it, but Diane is completely against it. He feels around the bathroom, blinded, and Diane states that it's because he keeps consuming mouthwash and wet wipes. He breaks the mirror, taking the sharp shard to cut the body because they need to eat to survive. Suddenly, they start to hear music putting on the Ritz and realize that it's Melissa's phone ringing. Robert feels around for it outside and answers the call, talking to whoever is on the other side. He throws the phone back outside and closes the door. Afterward, Robert starts acting more frantic as he starts choking Melissa, saying to kill the witch as it's the only way to end their suffering after she started it. Diane pulls Robert away from Melissa and punches him on the floor, accidentally knocking over the trash bin that's covering the snake. It immediately lunges towards Robert's face and bites him, but he takes the snake and bites its head off. Then, he uses it to whip Diane repeatedly. Melissa comes from behind and starts stabbing him with a shard of glass repeatedly, even after he's long dead. With the two of them left, they huddle together as Melissa starts slipping into insanity. Diane chips away at the wall endlessly, but she successfully makes an opening after prying away the cement blocks. She tells an asleep Melissa that she's going to check outside and she'll be back. The time passes, but Diane hasn't returned. When Melissa wakes up, she starts looking for her mother but sees Amy in front of her instead, blood dripping out of her cuts. The cuts turn into vines and grab Melissa, then a string of blood comes out of Amy's mouth, gagging her. She breaks free from the hallucination as Diane comes crawling back inside the room, drenched in blood. Melissa asks what she saw outside, but the disturbed mother keeps chanting that everything's going to be okay, even if she doesn't seem to believe it anymore after seeing the horrors outside. A sudden banging surprises the two, and a creature growls at them as they scream in terror.
Subscribe to watch more videos like this. Turn on notifications. And leave a like, it really helps the channel out. Thank you for watching.